beautiful epic, the Mahabharata, that very scripture that still lives so powerfully today throughout the world, where the genesis of the Mahabharata in the conversation of Kurukshetra between Bhagwan Sri Krishna and Arjuna, his friend, narrated the Bhagavad Gita. But today I would take you earlier into Katha, into the Bhagavad Puran that speaks about Bhagwan Sri Krishna had inadvertently stared at the moon on the night of the Chaturthi. And like this, this Leela, this extract from the Mahabharata tells us a very beautiful story. It goes like this. There was a man in Dwarka called Satrajit. He was an ardent worshipper of the sun, Surya Narayan. Propitiated by his worship, the Lord appeared before him and granted a wonder gem. This gem was called Shyamantak. The Shyamantak, the gem, was given to Satrajit. And the gem radiated such a dazzling light that the people of Dwarka thought that it was Lord Surya himself had given his own radiance through this Shyamantak to Satrajit. You see, that gem was used to give about what is known as about 80 tolas in terms of weight of gold every single day. That was the power of this gem. Lord Krishna, he asked to give that gem to the royal coffers of Dwarka, but Satrajit refused. And later, Satrajit's brother Prasin had gone hunting wearing the gem, and a lion devoured him. And Satrajit, when he heard about it, Satrajit, he blamed Lord Krishna that he had stolen the gem after killing his brother Prasen. To prove his innocence, Lord Krishna went in search of that gem. You see, the lion that had devoured the gem after killing Prasen happened to reach the cave of the fabled bear Jambavant. You remember Jambavant? Jambavant of the Ramayana. And Jambavant had slain the lion when the beast had reached his cave. But when he slayed the lion, Jambavant gave that gem to his daughter, Jambavati. And ultimately, Lord Krishna fought a duel. He went into battle with Jambavant to get back the gem. And eventually, my friends, during the course of the battle, Jambavant realized who he had fought with. His chosen Lord, Rama, but just in a different form. And along with the gem, also gave his daughter in marriage to Lord Krishna. Dear friends, when the gem was brought back, Lord Krishna was absolved of the entire blame, and Satrajit apologized to Lord Krishna. Dear friends, the very beautiful story is summarized in a shloka. And today I would like to remind you, some of you would say, well, Panditji, I have already looked at the moon on a Chaturthi, and maybe tomorrow some would inadvertently look at the moon. Panditji, what do I do? Am I to be blamed, or I have already experienced blame that really was not deserved for something or by someone? What do I do? Well, I would like for you to repeat this mantra after me, and I would say it slowly in small parts. And if you chant this mantra, we're told, according to Mahabharata, that you would be absolved of any wrongful blame that comes your way. So please repeat after me. I can't hear you this morning through the radio, but you can hear yourself. Please repeat. Om Simha Prasenam Vadhita Sinho Jambavatahata Sukumarak Marodistva Hesha Shamak Shyamantak Kaha. I'll repeat it again. Om. Come on, I can't hear you. Om. Jai Bhagwan. Om. Simha Prasinam Vadhita Sinho Jambvata Hata Sukumarak Marodistva Hesha Shyamantak Kaha. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. We're told that chanting this shloka, any person who sees the moon on the Chaturthi should not only chant this mantra, but drink maybe only water alone on the day of the Chaturthi observe fast. We're told, observe the fast from the Chaturthi to the Panchami, at least for the entire day. Some devotees go 10 days, some go 21 days. You see, the number even 21 also is very auspicious to Bhagwan Sri Ganesha. Dear friends, at least chant the mantra, fast tomorrow on the Chaturthi and receive the benefit, the benevolence of Sri Ganapati. Ganapati Jagavandana.